executive session at 6:30. Steve, the reason was? Okay, legal real estate, pledge. Approval, I have a motion to approve council minutes of September.
I have personnel. Thank you.
I'm sorry, yeah. Motion to approve council minutes of September 2nd.
Second?
Second.
Questions? Any all favor? Votes? Nick, you want, I'm sorry. Yeah, okay, motion carried unanimous. Thank you. Citizens to be heard. Name and address, please.
Captain, before you speak, I just want you to know that you're being videotaped and not by council.
Okay.
By a citizen, it's their legal right to do so. I just want you to be aware of that.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you for allowing me.
We have a 3-minute commitment, so if at all possible.
Okay.
Thank you. I'm sorry, go ahead.
Okay, well, thank you for allowing me to speak to you tonight. We're active volunteers for the Lord's Pantry in Downingtown, where I serve on the board of directors. We're longtime members of Central Presbyterian Church, sitting on several boards and committees that serve the community. You may have seen us down at the intersection of Route 30 and 113. We maintain the flower bed there for the last 15 years. I'm here tonight because we are committed to the well-being of our community, and we would petition the council to consider strengthening the borough's current ordinance concerning the control of dogs. Becky and I are both runners, and each run on the streets, parks, and trails of the borough about 5 days a week. In the past several months, we have noticed an increase in the number of dog owners walking their dogs without using a leash to control dogs. In July, while running right on the trail after, you can see it right from this window, a loose dog with the owner about 20 feet ahead with his back turned, the dog lunged at me and nearly bit me on the arm. I asked the owner why the dog went on the leash. He told me to shut up and keep running. On September 7th, Becky was running through Sunnybrook Park near our home when an unleashed large dog chased her and jumped up on her twice. Luckily, she was not hurt, but she could easily have been bit or injured by the large dog. The owner was unapologetic and took no responsibility for the attack. He told Becky that she would have been all right if she would just yell no at the dog. We were surprised that the borough ordinances do not specifically require that dog be on a leash when not on its owner's property. The code merely says it shall be unlawful for any person who owns or keeps an animal to intentionally or negligently permit any such animal to run at large in the borough in violation of provisions of the PA dog law. Running at large is not defined in the ordinance. The PA dog law simply says that a dog has to be controlled under the reasonable control of some person and does not define reasonable control. We feel that an undefined ambiguous terms like running at large and reasonable control leave the ordinance weak and open to interpretation. Each dog owner is left to assess the amount of control their dog needs, and as we have seen, some dog owners underestimate their level of control. Several municipalities in Chester County have strengthened the state law by specifically requiring that dogs be on leashes when not on the owner's property. They include Westchester Borough, Tredyffrin Township, West Whiteland Township, Atglen Borough, Cowan Township, and East Pikeland Township. Several more municipalities in Chester County strengthened their state law by requiring that dogs be on a leash when in a public park. They include Kent Square Borough, Kent Square Township, and East Bradford Township. East Cowan Township is currently working on strengthening their dog law following the mauling of an elderly couple with 4 loose dogs last October. Westchester Borough's ordinance is straightforward and clearly defines how a dog should be controlled in public. It states, any dog which is off of on any street, alley, or other public ground in the borough of Westchester or upon the property of someone other than the owner must be on a leash which is attached to the dog by a collar or harness and must be accompanied by or under the control of the owner. We feel that it's in the best interest of the residents and visitors of the borough, including dog owners and their dogs, to have a uniform, clear standard and procedure for controlling dogs. We urge you to consider strengthening the current ordinance to require that dogs be on a leash when not on the borough's property. This will help mitigate the potential danger and inconvenience caused by unleashed and unsupervised dogs and help ensure the health, safety, and general welfare of borough residents and businesses.
Thank you, Kevin.
Thank you for your time.
I gave you 3 plus a minute. I think if you can turn it over to the borough manager and I guess the mayor and the chief to look at that, and I think it's a great idea. I wouldn't let my go, I wouldn't let my go run away, so.
Yeah, I promise Kevin, we look at this, I know the chief and I already talked, and I'm going to follow up with Kevin, make sure we get some.
And they'll look into it.
There are copies of our current ordinance, what it's worded in, how Westchester is worded.
Oh, we're good, sample, that's good.
Yes.
Did you look at the other communities' ordinances, and in your estimation, did you think Westchester's was the best representation?
Well, they all are similar in tone when they specifically say dog must be on a leash, where ours says it has to be under reasonable control, which obviously a man who feels that everyone else is responsible, he'll know that his dog feels that it's under reasonable control. My daughter is my wife is a mean 110-pound woman, and she was.
She does nothing mean about it.
I mean, mean.
I'm sorry. And then you have one question.
Is the dog, the ones you've read or what you know, is it all in its own separate ordinance, like anything that has to do with the dog, or is there something specific about this and then dogs and parks or another thing?
Well, actually, if you further read the code, I think it prohibits dogs in parks.
Well, that's what I was asking, because that was something I think we should. Yeah. Reconsider is allowing dogs in the park, especially if you strengthen it with they have to be on a leash. So I just wondered if that was a whole comprehensive conversation.
And I think we'll look into that. Thank you very much for bringing it to our attention.
Okay, okay. That's good.
Thank you very much.
Except
anyone else?
Do you want me to hold the camera?
No.
She's a non-resident. Okay, Sarah, come on up, please. You're well aware of the 3 minute. Name and address, please.
Okay, I happened to look at the minutes. It's on the Downingtown website. And I noticed that the meeting is there for August 5th. But attached to it now is a public hearing that really didn't happen. And I'm wondering where all of this information came from. Because unless somebody had a cassette going or a monitor going, all of this is, it's definitely not debated. So I'm wondering, where did it come from?
Is it notes? Is it a transcript? Minutes?
And guys, can I ask Council, please address the President first, then we'll go through it, so we don't have to shout and match up there, son, please.
I was able to ask the others.
I'm sorry, I apologize. Please, for now, let's do it that way. Try to keep some work. Go ahead.
It does look like a regular court recording, a reporter doing all the typing here, but it's obvious that some things have been summarized, other things are totally off the wall and wrong. According to what I videotaped of that meeting. So I'm wondering, was my videotape used? It is on YouTube. I understand that, but I certainly
didn't watch.
You sorry?
I didn't watch.
No. So how did this come about? If you don't mind my asking, who was
they,
able to?
We take the minutes every meeting.
You take the minutes every meeting?
You take the minutes?
Sorry,
Mr.
Sorry.
Go ahead. We have a question. Well, I guess
he answered it. You know, really do. He has no authority to answer any questions, that's for sure. So, just so you know. So go ahead.
Okay.
I don't know what he takes, so.
Whatever. But there are numerous things that are wrong that were written here.
Well recognized, sir. Thank you very much.